friends, this video on motion in a plane, part 6, is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Please make sure that you have watched all the videos from part 1 to part 5 before going ahead with part 6. We will now study resolution of vectors. What do we mean by resolution of vectors? Resolution means nothing but writing a vector in terms of its components along the x-axis and y-axis. So we'll see how do we do that. So splitting a vector along its components, generally along coordinate axis. That means we will write a vector in terms of its components along the x-axis and y-axis. So that is what we will do here. So let us see how do we do that. Let us consider that we have a vector A. Now, if we say that this vector A is represented graphically in this way, let us suppose its position is represented by some point, which is this point, such that its value along the y coordinate and its value along the x axis are determined by this point. So this is my vector A. Now, what I want to do is I want to write A in terms of its component along x-axis and y-axis. So, how do we do that? If this is vector A, the component of A along x-axis, this is x-axis. So, component of A along x-axis is given by this length. This length determines the component of A along x-axis. So, this is AX. Similarly, the component of A along y-axis, which is given by this length, is nothing but AY, that is component of A along y-axis, right? And we also know that the unit vector along x-axis is denoted by I cap. Similarly, the unit vector along y-axis is denoted by J cap. So how do we represent this vector A? This vector A is nothing but the magnitude of A along x-axis into I cap plus the magnitude of A along y axis into J cap. As I already told you, any scalar quantity when multiplied by unit vector gives a vector. That means these two on multiplying is a vector. Similarly, these two on multiplying is a vector. So two vectors when added gives a vector. So you see, from this you can verify the properties which we studied in the previous slides, right? So, any vector A is generally represented in this way in terms of its components along x and y axis, right? Now, from this we can say, and also from the diagram, from this diagram, let us suppose this angle is theta. So, from the diagram, from the basic trigonometry, we can say that sine theta is generally equal to perpendicular P by H, perpendicular by hypotenuse. So, what is the perpendicular here? Perpendicular is nothing but this line and this is nothing but AY. And what is the hypotenuse? Hypotenuse is nothing but the vector A, right? Similarly, we can write cos theta is equal to B by H, that is base by hypotenuse. What is the base? Base is AX. So, this is AX divided by hypotenuse is A. So, from these two things we can say that AY is equal to A sine theta. From here we can say AX is nothing but A cos theta. Right? So, from these two relations we can write that AX square plus AY square is equal to A square cos square theta plus A square sine square theta. So this can be written as A square into cos square theta plus sine square theta. Again, from our trigonometry basics, we know that sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Therefore, this is equal to A square. That means AX square plus AY square is equal to A square. That means the magnitude of A is equal to root over AX square plus AY square, right? So, this is how we can write the magnitude of any vector in terms of its components along the x and y axis. So, in this we are basically, I told you, in resolution of vectors, we generally resolve a vector or split a vector along its components. So, this is how we represent a vector along in terms of its components along the x and y axis. So from this we find that the magnitude of the vector can be described in terms of its components along the x and y axis. So this is about the magnitude. Now what about the direction? So this is the magnitude, right? So how about the direction? Now when we talk of direction, we can say that from the previous slide, that is from this and this equation and this equation, what we do? We divide these two equations. So what do we get? We get Ay by Ax. If you divide those two equations, you get Ay by Ax is equal to A sin theta by A cos theta. Now A will get cancelled. So you get Ay by Ax is equal to tan theta. That is, theta is equal to tan inverse Ay by Ax. So this theta is nothing but the value which determines the direction of the vector A. Now if you very carefully look at the figure once again, you see that this theta is the one which can very clearly determine the direction of vector A. This theta will determine in which direction the vector A is moving. So whenever we talk of any vector, two things are important: magnitude and direction. So in this case, what we did, first of all, I told you how do we write a vector in terms of its components along x and y axis, right? Secondly, from this we found that the magnitude of any vector can be written in terms of its values, or its, secondly, we found that the magnitude of any vector can be written in terms of its components along the x and y axis. And the third point which we found here was the direction of the vector can also be represented in terms of its components along x and y axis respectively. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thank you once again.